Hello everyone, Ictus here, and in today's video I'll be showing you guys how to root the zSecurity Alvin CTF machine. This machine is hard rated, so if you don't have any experience on CTFs, this might look a bit hard for you. We have our winners here that got their prizes, and the first place got $100, the second place got $25, and the third place got 1 free month of VPN with the zSecurity VPN. So congrats to all of the winners. So now let's get to the machine itself. I'm going to deploy the machine and just wait for it to show me the IP address and initiate itself. I have already connected to the OpenVPN. So I'll just give this some time and we'll get right back to it. Okay, so we've got the IP address of the machine. First thing I'm going to do with its IP is actually run an Nmap scan on it. So the command I'll be using is nmap-sv-sc-a, and I will put the IP address for the machine. We'll just give this some time to run. If you're not familiar with Nmap, what Nmap does is actually scan for open ports, and sometimes it scans for vulnerabilities on the machine, but mainly it is used for scanning open ports on the given machine. So right off the bat, we can see that we have HTTP open and port 22 for open SSH. So let's go and have a look at the Apache server that we get. It says that it is under construction, and again, this website is still under construction. It is always a good idea to view the source code of any given website that you're doing either a pen test on or on a CTF, because there might be hidden stuff over there. So let's go have a look. I'm going to press Ctrl U and that will give me the page source. We can see right here that we get some basic HTML, and we can see right here a comment which says, "Alvin, to view the WordPress site, please remember to add alvin.ctf on etc hosts." So it basically tells us to add this virtual host to our etc host file in order to view the whole WordPress site. So we get two clues here. The one is that this machine runs WordPress, and that we have to add the alvin.ctf virtual host on the etc host file. Now this is great. So now I will go ahead and add alvin.ctf on the etc host file. Great, now it's done. You can see that I have added it over here. Now, we can go ahead and browse the WordPress directory on the given machine. Now that the website has loaded, we can see a basic WordPress site that has some zSecurity posts on it. So now we can go ahead and enumerate this website using WordPress scan. So now I will run the wp scan command. I will add the URL, which is this one. And I will specify another parameter that will enumerate vulnerable plugin versions. So the parameter that I will be adding is enumerate VP. Let's run it and let's see what we get. We can see a whole lot of information in here, but nothing that is that interesting. We can see that we have direct access to the upload directory and some other pretty cool stuff. But this is not in our interest. Since we have direct access to the uploads folder, it means that the web server is not configured correctly, which means that anyone that uses the website can view all of the files. For example, if you know the WordPress file structure, you know that after WordPress it goes WP content, and then from WP content you type plugins, and then you'll be able to view all of the plugins. So now that we can see that we have direct access to view the uploads folder, and I will show it to you right now, we can see that there is directory listing, which means that we can view all of the files within this given directory. And we can even get a teaser of what is running on this web server. We can see WP File Manager. So let's hit on the plugins. We can see right here that we've got some stuff, but we are interested in this one, the WP File Manager. Let's click it. And in order to view all of the versions, we have to click this readme.txt file. We can see that this is version 6. So let's go ahead and try and find an exploit for this. We can see right here that we've got an exploit for WP File Manager, which will give us unauthenticated remote code execution. So now I will click the row, I'll copy the file, I'll head to my desktop, and now I will wget the file. I will change its permissions, and now I will run it. So we can see that I have to supply a WordPress target URL. Let's do -h to see how we are supposed to use this exploit. We can supply a URL either with this parameter or this one, and we can upload a file using this parameter. So now let's use it. I will do -u and I will specify the target URL. And for the sake of the video, I will create a new file inside the desktop directory. So I created a txt file called test, and now I will upload that specific file. So again, we are running the exploit, we are supplying the URL for the target website, and now we are specifying a file that we want to upload. So let's run it. File upload failed. Let's see if I can actually specify the file in another way. Great, we can see that the file uploaded successfully. So it is either going to be on WordPress WP Content Plugins, WP File Manager, libphp, or it's going to be inside files. So let's have a look. We can see that it is on lib and files. We can view our txt file and we can view the contents of the file, which was test. So now we know that we can upload any file to this specific website. I will now get a reverse PHP cell and upload it to the target website in order to gain a reverse connection. I will locate the PHP reverse cell that is located in every single Kali Linux machine. This is the one. I will copy it from that specific directory and I will paste it to my current directory. Nice. So now I will edit this file and I will add my own IP from TAN0, the TAN0 interface, and I will specify my own port. I will copy my own IP address. I will paste it here and I will add port 4444. I will save the file, close this side, and now we are ready to run again the exploit, but this time we're going to specify, actually before I do that, let's try to rename this file to something much easier to type. So now we'll change the name of the file to cell.php. Now we can go ahead and run again the command. And now I will upload the file. It says that the file has been uploaded successfully. So I will clear my screen. I will start a netcat listener. And I will go back to this directory and click on cell.php. Let's see if it works. And yes, we can see that we gain a reverse connection to the machine. So now, all of this is great. If this was an actual pen test, you would actually stop here and write down a report. But in order for us to actually win or actually complete the CTF, we have to become root. So now I will spawn a basic Python PTY cell with the command python 3-c import pty.spawn bin bash. Great, I will also run export term equals xterm, and now I will be able to clear my screen. And I will also run stty row echo, you'll see why in a bit. I will background the session with control Z, I'll do stty row echo, and I'll press FG and go back to my cell, clear the screen again. And now we have tab auto completion. Let's try to enumerate things inside this machine. Let's try and go on the home directory. We can see that there is a user called Alvin, so let's change that directory into him. Let's list all of the files inside this current directory. We have desktop, documents, downloads, music, pictures, and report.txt. I will cut report.txt. And it looks like this is just a system report, which is telling us the current time. And it's telling us if everything is operational, which is true. So now I will cut again this report.txt because it actually tells us the time, which was 10:29. And now this is actually the wrong time, but it was 29 when we run it. Now it's 30. Let's see if this changes. And we can see that indeed the time changes every minute. So now we can assume that there is a Chrome job running in the background of the machine, which is generating this file and updating it every minute. This is a nice thing to know. I will clear my screen and now I will upload a Linux enumeration program called linpeas. So in order to download that, I have to go and search for linpeas, go on the GitHub repository. I will copy the address. I will create a new tab, and now I will do git clone and paste down the address. Let's cd into that. And we can see right here that we have linpeas.sh. I will start a Python HTTP server. So this actually acts like the Apache 2 web server, but the home directory for the website is the current directory. I will press enter, and now we have our website running on port 8000. And now in order to get the file from this machine to this one, I'll actually have to copy my IP address one more time. I'll go back to my cell and do wget http. I will add the IP, specify port 8000, and write down linpeas.sh. We can see that we have permission denied. This means that we have to go to the temp directory. Now let's run this again. And we can see that we got the file right here. I'll make the characters a bit smaller so that we can read the output of the file. Now I will change the permissions of the file. And I will run it. So let's give this some time to run, and I'll see you guys when we have the results. As you can see guys, our expectations were true. We can see that on the Chrome jobs tab, we have the basic Chrome jobs for every single Linux machine, but we've got this specific one that is running Python, Home, Alvin, Documents, Python, Checker, and it's running a Python file every minute. So now let's go and check out this file main.py on the Alvin user. Now I will cut this file and see what are the contents of it. We can see right here that this Python script generates the file report.txt that we saw before, and it's updating it every single minute because of the cron job. So now let's see if we can actually modify this file. As you can see, guys, I am able to modify the file, and if I do Ctrl X and Y, we can see that we actually modified the file. Now this means that we are able to add anything in this Python script that will be executed as the Alvin user every single minute. So now I will load up the reverse cell cheat sheet from Pentest Monkey, and I will copy this Python reverse cell script. I will edit the IP and I will add my own. I will use port 1234 for the listener. And now I will copy it, go back to the editing process. I will delete everything inside this file. And now I will paste the reverse cell that we got. I will save the file. I will open a new tab and run the Netcat listener. So now let's hope that when this minute passes, that we will get a reverse cell as the user Alvin. We can see, guys, that we got the reverse cell as user Alvin right now. So now we actually did a privilege escalation. So we got from www.data, we got to Alvin. So now I will run the Python 3 pty cell again. I will export term equals xterm, and now I will be able to clear my screen. And what we want to do now is actually privilege escalate to the root user. Before I do that, I always like to check my permissions as the current user with the command sudo l. We can see that we can run the nano command as anyone with no password. So this is great, we will be able to use that for privilege escalation in order to become the root user. So now I will go back and I will use a website called gtfobins. This website has a lot of privilege escalation ways for that you can use for different commands. Now I will search for nano. So now you can see right here that I've got to do sudo nano, control R and control X, and type this out. Before I do that, I'll background my session with Ctrl Z. I will do stty row echo once again. I will do stty row echo once again. And I will do fg to go back to my cell, clear my screen, and run the command sudo nano. Now I have to follow the instructions. I have to do Control R and Control X. And now I have to run this command. I will paste it right here. Clear my screen. And let me do ID. We can see that we are the root user. So we have successfully rooted this machine. So now all I have to do is do CD, listed directories. We can see right here that we got readme.txt, fsociety00.dat, and rootflags.txt. I will cut the root flag, and we successfully cut the root flag. That's all for now. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please click the like button and the subscribe button if you haven't already to not miss any other tutorials that I will be uploading. So until then, I'll see you in the next one.